And as we bring in meteorologist Jackie Thomas now, we're talking this lake effect snow, Jackie, mm-hmm. which has specific characteristics unto itself. And this is a lot of snow.
Yeah, a ton of snow out that way, and very different when it comes to our local lakes here. So just a completely different setup. And this is why we don't see what they're seeing out there by the Great Lakes, because locally you think of our biggest lake, Lake Winnipesaukee, and that is just so much smaller. So the biggest reason why lake effect snow doesn't really happen here or isn't common here is really just because of that size difference. The lake here in New Hampshire, roughly the area, about 72 square miles, and it's only 21 miles long. Lake Erie has almost 10,000 square miles of that surface area, so a lot bigger, a much different scale. Fetch is something that we talk about too. It's the distance that an air mass can travel over that body of water. And well, with a smaller lake, you're not going to have nearly as much time or distance for that air to move over the lake and allow that process to happen that forms the lake effect snow. Plus, Lake Winnipesaukee also prone to freezing as we get into the winter, right? A frozen lake means no lake effect can happen because you need that open access to that warmer water. So a lot of differences between our lakes locally and the Great Lakes and the lake effect snow machine happening out there.